Hi everyone. I'm Paul. Today we are going to present the core reflection process based on the onion model. The case below is about the problems in Mrs. Brown's educative professional practice. She is attending a professional development course in teacher training, where she and the supervisor will try to find a solution to the problem. Scene 1. Mrs. Brown in class.
Good morning, students. Today we are going to take the History Unit 3 test.
But you didn't tell us.
I told you in the last class about this test. You guys are always undisciplined and never pay attention.
I'm not taking that test. I didn't study.
If you're not going to take it, you all will get 0.
You're a liar. We're not taking that test. The atmosphere in the classroom was tense. The students did not respect their teacher. So after many setbacks like this, she decided to take a professional development course in teacher training. Now let's listen to the conversation between Professor Brown and the course supervisor. Scene 2. Mrs. Brown in the teacher supervision course.
In my classes, the students are very restless and I cannot teach the class. They always interrupted me. I'm very frustrated and I feel that this is not my profession. I do not think I will be able to continue teaching.
And tell me, what have you tried to do to improve the relationship with your students?
I've tried to be stricter with them, but it does not work. They are even more rebellious.
Maybe you should talk to your students and ask them how they feel about your classes and how they feel about your teaching.
I don't think that will help me. I'm there to teach history, not to listen to how my students feel. Also, I do not think emotions are really important in teaching.
You are wrong. As educators, we must make sure that our students feel comfortable and motivated in every class.
Oh, I did not see it from that perspective. I was just trying to teach my class.
And tell me, how do you see your role as a professional?
I think I'm a failure. Every class I teach is a disaster. I cannot maintain order or respect for the students.
I understand. It's a difficult situation. But tell me, what are your qualities?
Well, I am quite flexible and creative. However, the students take advantage of my flexibility. For example, they turn in their homework when they want. They leave the classroom without permission. And they do not listen to me when I talk to them. That is why I have chosen to become stricter.
Your qualities are very good, but you should find a balance between being flexible and being strict. Also, your frustration affects the classroom environment negatively. You have a lot of potential to be a teacher. You just have to trust your qualities and let your emotions and those of your students get more involved in the classes. This way you will give them more confidence and improve the situation inside the classroom.
You're right, I feel more relieved now. I realize that I have all the capacity to improve my teaching performance. From now on, I will trust myself and try to be more aware of my students' interests and needs.
After a short time, Mrs. Brown sent some emails to the course supervisor, in which she told him about her great progress. Now, her classes take place in a pleasant and productive atmosphere. Alright. That's it for this video. I hope it is useful for you to understand the levels of the onion model. Thank you for your attention.